Can a terracotta heater keep my greenhouse frost-free? Let's find out in this video, shall we? It's February, it's cold, the days aren't very long yet. However, the grow season has officially started here in the Netherlands. And so I do want to plant some seedlings in my greenhouse very soon. However, there is some frost in the forecast and I wanted to test if I can keep my greenhouse frost-free. My greenhouse is off-grid. I have been insulating it in the last few weeks, as you might have seen in my last video. However, there is no additional heat source, so no electrical heat and no compost heating setup. The only thing that warms up the greenhouse is the sun during the day and the thermal mass of my grow beds that warm up during the day and release that warmth during the night. So I want to test if a terracotta heater can keep my greenhouse above freezing temperatures. So what exactly is a terracotta heater? It is a simple, cheap, and off-grid way of adding some additional warmth to your greenhouse. The idea is that when you light a candle, the heat from the flame will be absorbed by the terracotta pots, and in turn, they will radiate that warmth to their surroundings. All you need for this is a terracotta plate, 3 or 4 spacers, a few terracotta pots that can precisely stack on top of each other, and 1 or more candles. Setting up your terracotta heater couldn't be simpler. First, you put down the plate and then you place the spacers on the edge of the plate. Then you place the candle in the middle and you light it. I won't do that in this example, but you get the idea. Then you put the largest terracotta pot on top of that upside down and then you work your way upwards to the smallest one. And that's really it. Now, depending on the size of your greenhouse or how big you want your terracotta heater to be, you can go for even 4 or 5 terracotta pots, but mostly I've seen people use 1, 2, 3 terracotta pots and stack them on top of each other. Bigger terracotta heaters can of course hold more candles and therefore will generate more heat, but that is completely up to you. So like I've said, there's going to be some frost in the coming nights. It's going to be somewhere between -2 to -5 degrees Celsius. That's around 25 degrees Fahrenheit. And I'm going to test if my terracotta heater will keep my dome frost-free. All right, see you tonight. So as you might be able to see, I am inside the dome right now. It is just past 10 o'clock in the evening and it is a crispy -2 degrees Celsius outside. Inside of the dome, it is barely above freezing, if I'm not mistaken. My compost thermometer says exactly 0 degrees Celsius, so it's on the edge. I'm going to light up the candle and I'm going to put the terracotta chimney into place. I'll get back here in the morning just before the sun starts hitting the dome, so before it starts warming up. And then, of course, I hope that the inside of the dome is still above freezing temperatures. Another way I want to verify this is by pouring some water on this little plastic plate over here that is sitting on top of my olla. The olla itself is embedded inside of my grow bed, so if the water is not frozen by the morning, then I know that the chimney has done its job and keeping the grow beds frost-free. All right, like I said, I'm going to fill this up with some water and hopefully it's not frozen in the morning. All right, here we go. Now we're going to put the big pot on top of there first, like so. So now the medium one and the little one on top. And it's easy as that. All right, welcome back to the garden. It's almost 8 o'clock in the morning. The sun is about to rise there in the east and it's -4 degrees Celsius. So even colder than last night. There's ice everywhere on the plants. I believe you call it rime. Anyway, let's check out the dome and let's see if the terracotta chimney has done its work. So yeah, everything is definitely frozen. And I believe the outside of the dome is also frozen. Yeah, but let's see what's going on inside. If I can get this lock to open. Yeah, there we go. Let's go inside. Close the door real quick. There we go. All right, so terracotta pot is over here, or the heater is over here. And the candle is still burning, as you can see. There is no direct frost on the plants. I have a little thyme plant over here. But it is pretty cold inside. The electronic thermometer doesn't read anything, so it is too cold. So probably below freezing, I'm afraid. My compost thermometer says just underneath zero. And the water experiment over here, yeah, it is, it has some ice in there, so not fully frost free. After this little setback, I was determined to try again, this time introducing a little bit more heat by using a few more candles. All right, second night, second experiment. It is about 10:30 in the evening right now. Outside it is -2 degrees Celsius, so much like the first night. The only difference now is that I'm going to use 3 candles instead of just the 1 to see if that keeps the dome warmer. All right, let's get going. The water experiment, let's see if this stays unfrozen. And just like last time, I'll be coming back here in the morning to see if I kept this baby frost free. See you then. Welcome back to the morning of the second experiment. It is just past 8 o'clock. It's a little bit cloudy and it is -2 degrees Celsius, so not as cold as the morning of the first experiment, but still very much freezing. The ground is still rock solid. The soil in my grow beds is still impenetrable. So let's see what the situation inside of the grow dome is. It actually feels pretty nice in here. The terracotta heater is still on. As you can see over there, the 3 candles burning. My digital thermometer over here, let's see. It says 0.3 degrees Celsius, so just above freezing, which is fortunate. My compost thermometer over here says about the same, 0.5 degrees Celsius, so also fortunate. And the water experiment over here is liquid as it should be, so that is strike 3. So the conclusion of my little experiment is that the terracotta heater has probably contributed to the overall temperature of the greenhouse during the night. However, I do have to be honest, it probably wasn't that much. In the case of my greenhouse, I probably need either a bigger terracotta heater or several more to keep it warm. Another thing is that I have been insulating the dome in the last few weeks, like I said. However, there are still a few air gaps around the door that I still need to cover up a little bit better. So it might have been that some cold have crept in during the night and disrupted my experiment a little bit. I do think that a terracotta heater can help with preventing your plants from freezing during the night. However, I think the most common way of keeping your greenhouse as warm as possible is to combine several things. So that means insulation, one or more heat sources, and thermal mass such as water or even sand. Thank you so much for watching the video and my little experiment. I like the terracotta heater, but what do you think? Have you used it before, or do you have some additional tips of how to use it better? Or do you have another cheap, simple, or off-grid way how you warm up your greenhouse? Let us all know in the comments below. Leave a like and I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.